All right, we are now back with Fire Emblem Awakening. You know how last time you said that the grinding would get shorter as we went along?
Yeah, and then you said, what about adult friendships?
Yeah, 6 hours. Oh, also, I need to share this. So something I discovered, let me go into the game first. Because I showed you this, Rhino. Something I discovered is that if you go into the barracks when it's when you go in normally, like they say something at the bottom. In a second. Yeah, I think we have to go through this first. It's Libra's birthday. Do you think Libra's a Libra sign?
Well, let's actually check.
Yeah, July 1st, so... Wow, still being called out. Okay, so, yeah, what it is that if you go in...
Libra is September 23rd to October 22nd, so no.
Boo! They fucked up. Anyway, when you go in here when it's late at night, you get people who will, like, call you out. Right now, Frederick's still calling me out, right? Like, hello, Maximus, resting for a change? But yeah, like, here. Yeah, let me center this. I took some screenshots of a few of the times where it was, where I went into the barracks when it was late and they're, calling me out on my shit for that. And then I decided to take some of my favorites and make an alignment chart out of them. So hang on just a second here. Rhino, go ahead and look in voice chat spam.
Okay, hold on. Let me put this in my browser so I can read it. Oh, geez, that zooms in a lot.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, lawful good is Cynthia.
Okay.
You want to read them as we go?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll start me off with an easy one. Yeah. It's the middle of the night, Maximus. Please go to bed soon.
Neutral good, Kiel. You've had a long day, Maximus. Rest up. Chaotic good.
Oh, right. Also me. Hello, Maximus. Time to go to sleep.
Just very blunt about it. Lawful neutral.
I am here to fetch you. No is not an answer.
Yeah, lawful good is like, please. Neutral good is, you should. And chaotic good is, do it. Then we have lawful neutral with Frederick.
Maximus, it's getting late. Are you patrolling the camp?
True neutral. Do you always stay up this late, Maximus? And then chaotic neutral. Wow, Maximus, do you ever sleep? Wait, are you undead? Neutral, and neutral is just, not telling me to go to bed, just questioning it. And then we have, the evil. Lawful evil. Maximus, it's late. No more snacking until tomorrow. And that's the most evil thing you could say. Long Q is neutral evil. I'm pretty sure you're Long Q.
What are you still doing up, Maximus?
And then, good old chaotic evil away over here!
Back, damn you! The darkness is upon us! My sword hand howls!
When I saw that one, I was very confused.
I would be too!
Sure, she's maybe because she's literally dragging you into bed, considering she's your wife. Also, fun fact, I kept, like, obviously exiting and re-entering the barracks in order to, like, get see more of the stuff. And it... Shershades kept showing up 3 times in a row, frequently. That was just Noir was also good, but I ended up not going for it. It was, Maximus? Did you think you were the only one here? So yeah, that was the thing that I spent 45 minutes on.
Hello, Yoshim.
There's a cat that wants out of my room now, hang on. I'm also probably gonna need to turn the fan on. Alright, give me a second. Alright, hopefully the fan on medium isn't gonna be too loud. Alright. Anyway, supports. What? Also, I'm noticing a trend. Every time, Gregor has no supports.
Well, that's your choice.
Good lord, we're gonna be here forever.
Well, here's the thing. We're not actually going to do mine today.
What?
I got them, but we're not gonna do mine today because that would take forever. So we're going to do the other ones.
But don't you want to set up for, like, the other ranks of yours?
Well, we could do that. Let's get through the other ones first and then see, like, how long it's taken.
Alright.
Let's start by going through the romance ones. The S ranks that we now have.
Oh, shit.
Hey.
This is both you.
I know. Hold on. Yeah.
Have y'all taken a look at a new game called Abiotic Factor? Never heard of it.
I saw Duncan was playing it. I haven't looked at it yet. Isn't it science survival? It's like, think it looked like standard crafting survival game. It's like, but instead of hit rocks against things, you were scientists in an abandoned lab. And there's like aliens or some shit. I don't know. Say, Wayne. What's wrong? You sound upset.
I heard you threatened my father last night.
Speak, oh fated companion. Spill your breast unto me.
Whoa!
Calm down, you. Calm down. Oh, wow, I don't think so. That's how that phrase goes.
I know what I said.
Anyway, it's about before. When I was testing you? That's business. What of it?
Sorry.
Yeah, so that wasn't really about cooking or gems or anything.
I was fucking with you.
I just wanted to see how important I was to you. I'm sorry for being dishonest. All part of the partner vetting process. Think no more on it.
It wasn't a phrase, it's a command. Give me your boobs! Well, I just noticed the sentence on screen right now!
I haven't even read it yet!
Yeah!
But there's still one thing I really want that you haven't given to me.
My cock!
Calm down, you. Maybe you could think about what that might be?
Penis!
What?
What you really want, huh? Hmm. Wait, is this round three? Mm-hmm. It's the final round. Alright, give me a second here.
Zip!
Calm down, Gigi's. Hmm. Well, have you figured it out?
No.
Is it a pony?
I see.
No, it's not a pony.
I already have a flying one.
Oh, I thought all girls loved ponies. So I'd certainly get you a pony. I'd get you anything you wanted.
Huh?
Really?
Well...
I'd do anything for the woman I love. I didn't mean to say that out loud. Wayne.
We're in this together.
Well, as long as I've spilled those beans, I might as well dump the rest of them out and then leave forever. That whole partner thing was a ruse. I just wanted to spend time with you. Oh, Wayne, that's the answer I've been looking for.
Hmm?
Wait, it is?
It worked.
All I ever wanted was to know how you felt, to hear you say those words. All I could ever get for you were home-cooked meals and expensive jewels. Does that mean you...
Right.
Yes, you silly man. I love you. I've loved you for so long. Be my partner, Owain. Not just in battle, but in life.
Let's go.
I swear to be at your side, in war and in peace, for as long as I live.
So some my VTuber was off-center.
Swordhand, would you like to be my best man?
I feel more like a third wheel.
Ah, that'll do.
All right.
I'll let you do that, because I swear the same.
Wait a minute. Which of his hands is Swordhand? Because if it's a left hand, that means Swordhand is wearing the ring, and therefore Morgan is married to Swordhand.
Just Anyways, I read it. Isn't that right, Bookhand? Yeah. Wait, what? Nah, I'm just messing with you.
Swordhand. I thought I had a friend! Damn you! Probably his right. Yeah, fair. All right. Now, Jerome and Nah, which is me and you.
Me and you, and you and me.
You there.
Hello, Nah.
I'm sorry. Her voice lines, I swear, never match the tone. It's like, I'm coming after you. Voice line, yeah! Like she's doing a jump kick. Meanwhile, text line, screaming. It's voice line, eh.
Maybe it's a sarcastic scream.
Hey, careful with those claws. They're sharp.
Well, you're the one who stuck up on me.
Well, yeah, I'm Wyvern Man.
What do you want exactly?
Vengeance.
Yes.
I want to clear the air. I think you may have the wrong idea. I don't dislike you, Nah. Far from it, in fact.
Huh? So why do you jump on Minerva and fly off in the middle of conversations?
Because you're weird. I don't know. Perhaps I don't know how to respond to a woman so interested in me. As Wyvern Man, I have very many of them. Though honestly, I've never been good at talking to people in general. I do wear this mask for a reason. Because I'm Wyvern Man.
Oh.
So I see. Guess I can understand.
Wyvern Man.
But really, it does nothing to hide your poker face.
Wyvern Man.
I'm just like everyone else underneath it all.
Wyvern Man?
Yes.
I know that now. It just took me some time to come to that realization. So.
So?
So in the interest of starting over, I'm Wyvern Man. And I'm wondering if you'd like to play a game together. You could choose it. I promise I won't fly away on Minerva this time. I have a different wyvern to fly away on instead.
Whoa. Really? You'd do that for me?
Naturally.
Yes. I feel like I owe it to you, after all. And I suppose I could loosen up a bit. Plus, if we're going to be friends, then I have to do things for you. Friends do that, right?
Can we get married then?
What the fuck?
I just dropped that on his head out of nowhere.
I've decided that I'm no longer going to run away from you. We can be friends, and this is our first time properly interacting. Marry me!
I feel like I made a mistake.
Is that what the game is called? I'm not quite familiar with the rules.
Trust me.
No, you silly man. I mean, for real.
Where is this coming from?
Don't you realize why I've been following you around all this time?
You're trying to see me without my mask. We've been over this.
It's because I've fallen in love.
Stop! That's enough.
I never thought I'd see this guy with a blush sprite.
Why don't we pretend to marry for now and get to know each other? That'll be fun, right?
Ah, there's the jump kick again.
That'd be fun, yeah! Right? That'd be fun, right? Karate chops him in the face. No!
No, I don't want to pretend. I truly do want to get married.
Yes, but perhaps if we wait until we're both a little older.
Whoa. Then you have to promise.
I'm curious now.
This is like the mother's side of it coming out, I swear.
Yes.
I swear on my honor as Wyvern Man that I will consider it. Eventually.
I'm more than willing to wait for a man that piques my curiosity like you do.
Wyvern Man.
After all, what's a few years to a mannequin? So is not a dragon. Yoshim, she can turn into a dragon because she's kind of like a dragon person, but in standard Fire Emblem lore, actual dragons are gods.
Yeah. She is
She's like a demi person.
She's a person who can turn into a dragon. She's like a druid, but only dragons.
But like that level 20 druid who lives ridiculously long.
All right, now, Noir and Inigo. This is both me.
Hey there.
I missed the Jerome and Nah S rank. We just finished it. Sorry, Solar. I'm concerned about his relationship with his wyvern. It'll be fine.
There, yeah, she and Nah just might fight one night.
There you are. I was looking for you.
Huh? Oh, that's interesting. They said Sylvia says druid is closer to Togwell, and mannequins are more like demigods.
That's true. A Togwell is basically a druid that can only turn into one type of animal, and it's like a giant version of it.
A cup of tea with you. Interested?
What? Why? What's going on?
It's not very ladylike to fib, you know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're a little bit about being ordered to keep the hyenas at bay.
I didn't lie. Those were my orders.
Quite.
But you weren't quite telling the truth either. Hmm? Something tells me you wanted to be one of those hyenas.
Well, how did you know?
Ha! Let's just say I have a gift for reading women. Also, I asked Crom. He said he had no idea what the fuck you were talking about.
I was the only one you never flirted with.
Bullshit! Never flirted with Olivia! Wait! No, he did, actually. Before he realized she was his mother. Never mind.
I do like how this is like she was on the other foot instead of her being the aggressor all of the three times. He's like, aha, now I have you.
You even flirted with a sign in front of the baker's shop one day. I felt...
Were we not going to elaborate on that?
Nope, I'd rather leave that to the imagination.
Was it a sign that looked like a woman, or was it literally just a wooden sign with writing on it?
I'm imagining it's one of those ones where it was like the baker holding a plate of buns or something, and he was leaning over and just like, hey there.
I felt left out, you know, and hurt, and crying.
Sorry, what was the last one?
I felt angry! Blood and thunder, mortal! My emotions are not to be trifled with! Now flirt with me!
Or die.
Anyone who's seen expiration date from TF2 will know what I'm talking about. Seduce me! Says the spy to the scout. I'm not sure I could really do that right now.
A gift for reading women? Ha! What a joke. You've got a gift for misreading women. That's why you always get turned down. I just want a chance to turn you down too.
Wow!
This is a strange S rank so far.
Well, Noir, the reason I didn't flirt with you is because you're kind of scary. I didn't want to set you off and wind up as an oversized pincushion for your arrows.
Oh, I see. It's not like I get mad on purpose. I can't help it. Wah.
Cripes, don't cry. I mean, yes, I was a jerk, but you fired about 100 arrows at me. What do you say we call it even and start over, huh?
But I had to work the hyenas.
I know, and I appreciate what you were trying to do. Listen, I was worried about making you angry. That's no lie. But I also thought you were different. Kind of ethereal, if that makes sense. Like something mortal hands weren't meant to touch. Anyway, that's why I always hesitated. But I'm done hesitating.
Found his mojo.
I'm going to ask what I've been wanting to ask you all along. Will you stop firing arrows at me? I mean, will you marry me?
What?
What? Isn't that a bit sudden?
Someone says it.
Did you not just hear what Na and Jerome were doing?
I'm tired of beating around the bush with you. This is all I've ever wanted.
I'm flattered, but it's just so unexpected.
Ha! You're adorable when you blush and fly into a panic.
If we do this, you have to stop flirting with other girls.
Huh? Well, sure, that's the sure.
Saying sure twice makes it feel less sure.
Well, it's hard to feel sure when you're pointing a blow at me!
I'd hoped you would learn your lesson by now.
Stop, please, I promise I'll... Wait, learn my lesson? So that whole bit about hyenas was just a lie!
Oh, it was no lie, for I have a slave-ridden scavenger in my sights right now.
Wait, me?
Time to silence that philandering cackle for good.
Have mercy! I repent!
I
need to
first
point...
First of all, that was really long, but I'm not sure.
I need to point something out. So I discovered recently, like, what happened for a couple of the S-rank pairings that we weren't going for. I learned what happens if you pair Inigo and Na, and what it is that Na, like, Inigo is not especially interested, and Na forces him to marry her under threat of murdering him.
I think this is just his lot in life.
Yeah, I think Inigo just gets fucked, like, in the bad way. And it's like,
yeah, I agree, Sylvia and Yosha, you're not wrong.
I might replay this at some point in the future, and if I do, I'm kind of considering putting him with Cynthia, because I can't imagine Cynthia doing something like that to him.
Alright.
Whereas Sephiroth would just be a bitch, Kiel would probably, like, put him through crazy-ass training, and I think those are the only, Well, yeah, then there's Lucina, but, eh. But yeah, still, eh. Weird. Anyway, Cynthia and Brady now. And once again, this is both of us.
What do you mean, once again, it is both of them?
Because it was both of us for, non-Jerome. As in, like, you voice one and I voice one.
Oh, okay. I was like, both of what? Brady!
Man, this army is really weird. A bunch of people suddenly wanted to, all force other members of the army to marry them. Me, sitting in the corner, sips tea. What's wrong, Cynthia?
The army is more like one giant bush of a family. To be fair, the issue wouldn't come up if the children hadn't been here.
I
owe you an apology.
I am glad they at least make it so that you can't ship the children with the adults, though it bothers me slightly that you can ship the children with yourself.
Shrug. Huh?
What? Why?
Right. Issa told me. The truth, I mean.
Kermit/Max sipping tea, but that's none of my business. No, Yoshim, quite the opposite. This is all my business. I caused all of this.
My mother was showing me Kermit memes last night.
Please tell me she showed you Star Wars with Kermit as Palpatine.
No, I'm trying to remember one. I'm failing.
I'm literally just Googling Kermit meme right now. Yeah, no, I'm seeing some stuff here. Me after completing one of the 20 things I'm supposed to do, and he's just laying on the ground.
I don't know, just continue.
Okay.
I don't think she was specifically looking for Kermit memes, but she likes to browse Pinterest.
Sorry, I just saw this one, and then I'm going to read this one, and then I'm done. The human body has 7 trillion nerves, and some people manage to get on every single one of them!
Huh.
She did what? Then you... Yep.
Know that it was really you helped me all those times? Yes, I know.
I told her not to say anything. Why'd she have to open her big yap?
It's not her fault, really. I started quizzing her about all her secret hero moves, and she just cracked.
Yeah, see? She didn't open a yapper then. Ooh, I'm gonna have me a few words with that stool pigeon.
Honestly, it's your fault for picking her. I mean, she's not exactly the type to take secrets to the grave, is she?
Yeah, maybe not.
So I just want to know why, Brady. Why me, my anonymous savior?
He shipped literally everyone else before himself. To be fair, Shersha didn't show up for a while. I was worried this game wasn't going to have anyone I was interested in at all. Fire Emblem Fates, I saw the character that I was interested in the fucking tutorial. So... Ah, horse pucky. What? I ain't nobody's savior.
It's horse shit.
I know, but I've never heard of pucky. I just couldn't stand to watch you charging around all reckless and stuff. You were bound to get hurt, and I couldn't bear to see it. You're like a little sister to me, Cynthia, you know?
A sister? Well, that's unfortunate. See, because I don't think of you as a brother.
Yeah, well, you know what? Just forget I ever said...
Yeah, see?
I was glad when I heard it was you. I like you, Brady. A lot. Like, a lot, a lot. Knowing that the man I like have been watching over made me... Oh, she's cute when she blushes. It made me really happy.
I'm sorry, Cynthia.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to, I don't know, say all that, I guess.
Oh, I'm not Cynthia. All that sister stuff was a bunch of hooey. I'm crazy for you. Always have been. That's why I shadowed you. I mean, sure, I wanted to keep you safe. Mostly, I just wanted to be near you, and I didn't have the guts to say it.
Oh, this is the best day ever. I get the real answer to the mystery, plus the guy I like.
Yeah, it's a pretty good day for me, too.
Oh, that was sweet.
His accent changed like 3 times during that.
Look, I wasn't going to bother you about it.
All right, hey, Yarn and Lucina now.
Yarn!
What?
What is it? Everything all right? You're all worked up.
I've just been so impressed with your performance in combat lately. I had to come and tell you.
Wow, thanks, Lucina. The old rabbit run for your life instinct is still there, but I feel like I'm getting better.
You're a whole different person out there. It's amazing to witness.
You're exaggerating, but I'm glad. So, if I've been doing so well, do I get a reward?
Very well.
Of course, you name it. If it's within my power, it's yours.
Will you be my girl?
Huh?
What?
I always hated being a coward and a burden on everyone else. I wanted to change, but it wasn't until we started watching out for each other that I learned how. You taught me what real strength is, and I learn more from you every day. But I've got a long way to go, and that's where you come in.
Yarn.
Mm-hmm. I love you, Lucina. You make me a better tag, well, on the field and off. I want to be with you always.
You have my gratitude.
I would like that very much, Yarn.
What? You would? Really?
Very well.
You've become so brave, so dedicated. It's true that when we first met, you were like as not to turn and run. But watching you conquer your fear has been an inspiration to me. Yeah. Huh. Seeing you grow has filled me with pride, as much as if it were my own improvement. I want to keep sharing in your life, and I want you to share in mine. So yes, Yarn, I love you too.
After hearing that, I feel like I just grew about 100 times stronger. With you by my side, I'll become a real warrior yet.
And now there are royal rabbits.
Yep. And now, Kiel and Laurent. Which I think is the last one out of the pairings. Aw, royal bunnies.
All right, me. Hello, Cal.
Laurent!
Something amiss. Ought I be concerned that the sight of me sends you reeling? We're glad you lent an ear to any troubles you may be having. And troubles I am the cause of, doubly so.
No, you're fine. It's me. I need to apologize.
Oh.
I snapped at you before. Would you stop coming by to check up on me?
Indeed.
I'm gonna categorize your behavior as snapping.
How about this?
Haha. What's more, I thought the matter was decided as a misunderstanding on my part.
And hey, great way to secure the Tagwell line. If the only surviving members of the race are also the royal family, they're going to be the most well-protected rabbits ever.
And the most likely to be assassinated.
Most likely to be targeted for assassination. You think they'll succeed?
I mean, technically speaking, according to what Lucida said, they succeeded on just assassinating the head of the whole freaking country.
Yeah, but here's the thing, Rhino. This time, Donald is his father.
That's true.
It wasn't.
Truly, it took the mixing of the lowest of the low and the royalty to create the ultimate person.
The ultimate life form.
Yes, there you go. I fear I don't understand.
Yeah.
I was jealous. I started watching everyone but me, and it made me a little crazy.
Now I really do not understand.
Believe me, I'm as shocked as you. I'm still confused about what it all means, what I feel for you. But I wasn't being honest with you or with myself, and which is clear. So I wanted to go ahead and apologize for that, no matter what happens down the line.
Intriguing.
If I may confirm, you feel it's possible, but not definite, that you bear an affection for me.
Yes.
And you see the potential for growth into some form of relationship down the line.
Sorry, I know it's all pretty vague.
My thanks.
I see no call for the apology. This is a welcome development. For I am quite certain in my affections for you, Kiara. And as a byproduct of possession, jealousy is a favorable addition to the equation. After all, the ultimate goal here is to be possessed, is it not? Still, I must say, the frank compulsion to apologize immediately is very you. Ha. Huh.
Laurent.
Say.
You have asked me to continue to watch you, Kiel. I would now ask you to do the same.
Well, sure, but how do you mean?
I've only just begun to show my worth as a possible spouse and mate. However, I still have work to do before I am what the layman might call dreamy. But given proper training, I am confident in my ability to steal your heart.
Wait, do I have a palace?
What?
Persona 5.
Oh, okay. Therefore, I would ask that you observe me in this process and offer advice.
Thank you.
You want me to watch you at a dreamy training?
Come.
That is it exactly.
Well, I've had worse offers.
He didn't blush at all during that one.
Yes.
Proper training as in a way to pierce her armor. Jesus. Alright, I believe... Yeah, that, we're now done with the,
Is it time for kid friendships now?
Yeah. Let's do Cynthia and Sephora now.
Oh, boy. I'm impressed you showed up.
Fine.
Oh, I wouldn't miss it. I'm looking forward to that apology.
Just try me.
Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to, showing you that justice always prevails.
Whatever. It always comes back to that with you, doesn't it?
Leave it to me.
A hero's fate is to see justice done. Meanwhile, villains like you are fated to get kicked around by us heroes.
Well, since you seem so full of energy, we'll start with a foot race. Keep up if you can.
Alright.
Huh, I'll leave you in the dust.
Hops on horse.
Yeah. How are you able to keep up?
I've had enough.
Keep up? I was in the lead.
What? That's ridiculous.
This whole duel is ridiculous. One challenge down, and we're no closer to a resolution than when we started. On to round two.
You can do it!
Swordplay, was it? As you wish. Have at you.
I wanted to fade out and fade back into Cynthia talking to Crom, be like, and so someone just showed up and stabbed her, I don't know!
Aw. Oh my gosh, what? That hurt, you lunatic! No one cares if your ugly face gets ruined, but I'm pretty.
Bob. Youch, your insults don't hurt as much as these dumb wooden swords.
Okay, time out. I'm exhausted.
Let's see you recuperate with little snack, hmm? On to the eating competition.
So stuff. Can't eat another bite.
Don't talk about food. Can't even move.
What?
I think we tied again. This is stupid. Three rounds and we still don't have a winner. I don't even care anymore. I'm completely wiped. I'm not moving another inch today.
Me too. Let's just forget the whole thing.
I always thought you were just a loser with big loser fantasies. You've actually got guts and heart.
And I guess you're not just an emotionally stunted ice queen. Yes, you are.
Yeah, there was literally nothing throughout all this that would give you that idea that she's not.
You got fire in your belly. That was the hot sauce. I can maybe even learn from you.
Wipe that smile off.
We're kind of a really matched pair, huh? How about I let you call the duel a draw and we try being friends?
Let me, huh? Ooh, so generous. But when you think about it, our mothers were friends as much as they were allies.
Cynthia's mother is Sumia, right?
Yeah.
And Severus is Cordelia. Did they ever even interact?
I mean, they've both been the Pegasus Knights, so probably. Maybe we were fated to be the same all along.
I'm too tired to think about fate.
I'm barely keeping my eyes open here, too. I say we take a nap and then go for a cup of tea.
Right.
Deal, but I get to pick them.
Heh, you fun. It's alright.
Yeah, Cynthia and Nah now!
Unbelievable, even after that, Cynthia keeps begging me to transform. I'm not a prop, and I'm certainly not the Wicked Queen of Darkness. Really, the nerve.
Hey,
I'm back again. Miss me? Speak of the Wicked Queen. Aw, I missed you too. Anyway, I was hoping you'd finally be ready to transform and let me up on your head. Talking to you is like arguing with a wall. A stupid wall. A wall who only wants one teeny tiny favor that will only take 5 minutes. Please, I'll climb it down as soon as I'm done. Huh? Cynthia? Your smell.
Huh?
What? What smell? I don't smell. I took a bath last week.
Nope.
No, that's not what I... Mannequins can tell a person's intentions by their scent, apparently.
Since when?
Oh.
Wow, really? That's kind of amazing.
So?
I'm sensing that you actually want to be friends with me.
Yep.
Well, yeah, of course. So that's the reason you've been hanging around with me this whole time? Well, what else would it be?
How did you not smell that until now, if you can apparently do that?
Because she hadn't bathed before now.
It's medieval times.
Doesn't mean they don't stink. You're always so serious. I didn't really know what you like to do for fun. I figured if I can get you to transform, we could have a few laughs and break the ice. I thought you were just, I don't know, making fun of me or something. Well, I really was looking to have fun, just not at anybody's expense. It's no fun for me unless you're having fun too.
Oh.
Cynthia, I think I may have misjudged you.
Yeah, see?
So is that a yes? Can we be friends?
Hey, thanks.
Of course we can be friends.
All right.
Yay! Friends at last! Now transform and I'll scream up and storm my, and roar my mighty battle cry. Yeah. I didn't say anything about that. Jump kick.
All right. So I also decided to do all of Krom's supports that he had. He has significantly less than I do. Sully, Vake, Frederick, Maribel, Guys, and Livia, aside from the ones that we've already done. And then, all right, let's see. Let's see which ones we have that aren't just with me. We might do Sayri's just because, oh, right. Also, I got Sayri her own weapon, and I also leveled her all the way up and then classed her into Assassin.
Okay.
I made her usable on the team because she feels plot relevant. I feel like it makes sense to use her.
Okay.
Oh yeah. Also, I got Alyssa her own named weapon. there's Alyssa and Frederick. Let's do Alyssa and Frederick.
Huh? That's odd. I'd have sworn he was over here some. Ha ha! There you are, Frederick. Jeez, why the grumpy face?
Yes.
I fear this is the only face I have, m'lady. Was this something you needed?
What are you doing back here?
Well...
inspecting the contents of our armory for worn or damaged equipment.
Ooh, I'll help!
No...
I cannot allow that. You could cut yourself or accidentally...
Do you think I'm an idiot? Honestly, Frederick!
Forgive me.
I think you are a princess whom I am duty-bound to keep safe.
Yeah, boring.
Really?
Was that something you needed from me?
Huh? Oh, no. I mean, yes, but I wanted to ask you a favor.
Right.
How may I serve you?
Mm-hmm. I want you to train me like you do the others. I'm tired of struggling to keep up with everyone. I want to hold my own.
I see.
A fine idea. It would be my pleasure to assist in your training. Though I must warn you, I am not a gentle teacher. Be certain you want this.
Right. Oh, I am. She's going to die.
First, I need you to put on Kiel's armor. I'm dying.
Owain and Inigo. Ah, the dramatics.
Hello, True Two Fruit. I believe this is only the second Fire Emblem he's played.
I've played Three Houses, which I loved. I played this one, and I've played a decent amount of Fates, though I haven't even finished one of the routes yet. And... I don't know how I would compare this to Fates, because I haven't beaten Fates yet. I am enjoying this more than Three Houses, because Three Houses has a lot of things that are better, in my opinion. But this, the supports are a lot more, there's a lot more to the supports here, and you have a lot more control over, like, downtime and such. You can choose if you just want to instantly go to the next big story thing, instead of it being like, alright, you wait 3 weeks.
Yeah, I think they kind of got a little Persona-y in Three Houses, which, I mean, is fine. It's a little departure, though, although I did appreciate they're actually having... you could technically make anyone anything if you had the stat requirements for it.
Yeah, I feel like if they had... Basically, Three Houses has a lot of quality of life things that I think are better. Basically,
repairing weapons.
Yeah, repairing weapons... being able to, like you said, being able to, make people into whatever class you want and just kind of work on getting their stats up there. Allowing them to use any weapon regardless of, like, what class they are. Well, more or less.
That cheaper weapons are technically better at times because they're lighter and thus you can potentially hit more.
Yeah. But overall, I would say Fire Emblem Awakening is better. Three Houses definitely has a lot of upsides, though. Fates, I don't know yet, because again, I haven't even finished one route yet. But, so we'll see about that one. I am liking the characters in Awakening a lot. They stand out a lot more than the ones in Three Houses.
I mean, Three Houses, I think...
Three Houses had a lot more.
Yeah, they dump them all onto you at once.
Yeah, like, here I could easily remember, like, character, this is their gimmick. Whereas in Three Houses, it's like, oh, Kaspar, he's, like, one of the four people who just likes to fight.
Well, have you come up with a name for that sword yet?
3 hours is too tedious for my taste. It's a prime example of more is not always better. I can see that. I still really like free houses. I do like free houses. If you have a free house, I'll take it. I'm still not sure where to start, or why to start, honestly.
All right, a Wayne's D&D campaign.
Right, yeah.
Come on, a fine sword like that, it practically shouts its name to you. Just listen. Shh. Listen.
Nope. Apparently I don't speak sword. Help me out, Hero Wayne. What does it say to you?
Try to focus.
This sword wants to be named... Flameclaw Wyvern Born the Foe Slayer.
I don't think that'll fit in the text box.
Huh? Oh, it just did, see?
That's very long. Okay then, what about this spear?
I already named that one. That's the Skyfire Lightning Slicer.
You don't really slice things with a spear, Owain.
Skyfire Lightning Poker.
All right, then.
Left speechless, huh? I can't blame you.
Remind me again how this is mental warfare and not just you being mental.
Yeah.
You'll understand once I carve the name into the weapon. Here, watch. Impressive, right?
You did it in like 2 seconds. Strangely enough, yes, it does look better.
Huh. A weapon with a strong name makes the wielder feel stronger, too. It fills you with confidence on the field of battle and lets you fight to your fullest.
My.
That kind of makes sense, which scares me.
So let's get you started. Think of a good name and then carve it into your blade.
Quite.
All right, I will.
Joe, no. All done.
It's a masterpiece.
Wow.
That's the spirit. Let's have a look.
Yes, I...
What do you think? A vast improvement over your ridiculous names, I think you'll agree.
Inigo, these are just the names of girls who'd spurned your advances. God, there must be 200 names on this thing.
Mental warfare, my friend. With no more room for names, I have to succeed.
Yeah, but you carved out half the metal. The sword's totally worthless now.
Huh? Oh. Whoops.
Three House's emphasis on perspective, though, is really cool, although Fates did that already.
Three House's and Fates, at least from the little bit of Fates that I've played, and from the 4 playthroughs of Three House's that I've done,
I'm pretty sure in Fates there actually is a bad guy.
Well, in Three Houses, there's a pretty obvious evil route. It's just...
Yeah, that's true.
It just gets portrayed as less evil while you're on it.
Which is what evil should do.
And like I said before, that I feel like the different route of Three Houses feels like a fan fiction written by someone who just really hates Rhea. Because... a lot of the justifications and characters are written completely differently than in any other route. It's like a whole different, like, it's an entirely different universe, not just, oh, you made a different choice. Whereas Fates also definitely feels like there's a pretty definite bad guy. Severa and Kiev. Oh, one other thing about Three Houses one thing about Awakening that I like much better than Three Houses. In Three Houses, if you got the support up between characters, you then had to essentially juggle which one had more support points in order to get the paired ending you wanted at the very end of the game. Whereas here, it's just... you get them up to S rank, and then you choose the one you want to S rank, and then it's locked in.
Yeah, they did make it really hard to do intended pairings in Three Houses. That's one thing I'll definitely say. It's like, even you, it's just like, get your options, and at the end of the game, you pick one. Instead of here, where you just kind of do it whenever you get there. And then for everyone else, it's just like, whoever they just happen to have the most points with, even if they're quote-unquote maxed out with multiple people.
And I remember, like, in one playthrough, I, like, had, like, specific pairings I wanted, and I was literally looking at the list for 20 minutes straight doing something like, let's see, Bernadetta's highest ranking is with Raphael, and then, let's see, if we go down a bit, Dorothea's highest ranking is with you, but that person's highest ranking is with Bernadetta, but that's lower than the one of Bernadetta and Raphael, and just, you know, that...
Oh my god, you need multiple charts.
Yeah, it was like a, yeah, it was a thing.
So others get out of S rank, give you S rank with someone first here. Yes, Sylvia, you only get one S rank.
Each character gets one S rank, and there are limited options. You cannot S rank everyone.
No gay.
I think Henry is an actual gay option, though. I'm gonna look this up. Fire Emblem Awakening gay option.
Secretly, you find a spoiler in the gay option is you! You and that one clone of you.
Oh, no, actually, apparently they don't exist. I swear that, I swear you could have, that a male could, marry Henry and a female could marry, Tharja. I could have sworn that was a thing.
Nope.
I swear I remember hearing about that. Alright.
Hey, good afternoon, Sevda. You're looking well. Better, but not great. Or good, really, but better. Now you need to focus on the delivery. In time, it will be fluid and natural. Still, I suppose I should thank the gods you've even come this far.
The fact that Kiel is just putting up with this, by the way. Instead of just ignoring her.
If it makes you feel better and tripping less in those absurd shoes you gave me. Oh, and I combed my hair this morning. 100 strokes exactly.
Wow, that would take forever.
And it looks lovely. There's just so much...
I'm sorry to give her Sephra's inflections.
There's just so much to remember.
Oh no, her influence.
I'm always sure I'm forgetting something.
The fact that you're managing to do, like, an Irish with a Valley Girl accent is impressive.
I guess it's just good that I'm improving. As you will continue to do, I'm sure. Plus, you have the advantage of being naturally beautiful.
Thank you.
Well, thanks, I guess.
Huh?
What, is there something on my hands? You keep staring. Your fingers are so long and pretty. I don't know how I didn't notice before. Kiel, now that is a very sweet and ladylike compliment. I'm so proud of you right now. Does that mean a pass?
Right.
Pass, you're going to be valedictorian. I hereby name you a graduate of Sephra's finishing school for warrior ladies. Hehe, warrior ladies. Oh, that's rich. That's... Uh-oh.
Huh?
What is it?
Actually...
I've been so focused on remembering what you taught me, I think I forgot other stuff. Oh, God.
How
gods.
If I start talking like this?
I don't remember how to fight. What? I'm trying, but nothing's coming back. It's all a big blank. Which end of a sword do you hold? It's the pointy end, right? Ouch! Damn it, wrong end. I knew this girly stuff was a bad idea. Well, worry not, dear. I'm here to help. We'll enroll you in Sephra's combat class for Lady Warriors next. You'd better hope I've forgiven you by the time I graduate. Just don't go and forget how to act like a lady this time. You'll thank me once this war is over and you're on the prowl for love.
Come
I'm
on.
Already married to Laurent! When it gets started already, I can feel my muscles disappearing.
Never... I don't know if she is, Sylvia.
Don't ever make me do that again!
You chose.
I started accidentally, and then I was like, well, in for a penny. All right, let's see. I'm seeing if there's a... Oh, right. I wanted to see if Henry Sully had anything interesting.
Oh, God. It's been so long.
Hey.
Hey, Henry.
Really?
Hi, Sully. Support ends.
Need something?
Nah.
Just wanted to chat to you in a second.
Kiel can only retain one mastery at a time, really. Kiel is trying to learn ladylike manners, but Kiel already knows four moves. Delete a move to make room for ladylike manners?
It's not completely sure you wound up with a pleading and agent account. Yeah, but don't get me wrong, I'm happy you're singing spells from our side.
Happy to help. Just point me at the enemy and I'll curse him to gooey bits! Pshoo, pshoo, pshoo! Yeah!
Right, you specialize in the dark magic stuff, don't you?
Not anymore, ever since the class change. Apparently a dark mage can't use dark magic.
What?
I hate my life!
So what's the deal? Can you really take an enemy out with just a curse?
Yeah, watch! Fuck! See, he's dead. Yep, sure can. Just takes a little bit of time and planning. What about you? Ever curse anybody?
Oh, yeah?
A knight is honor-bound to face her enemy in fair and honest combat. We never resort to such dirty, underhanded means. I mean, the enemy might. So, Henry, I got a favor to ask. I need you to slap a curse on me sometime. No big deal, whatever's easiest.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. I'll need a pound of flesh, 7 fingernails, and your left kidney. Yeah, I jest. A single hair will do just fine.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
It is so hard to just pluck a hair out. Forget it being painful. That shit holds on tight. I'm not able to do it. Like, I guess my hair is a bit thicker than most, I guess. But still.
Mine's thin, so it's more difficult, but I've done it out of my beard before.
Henry casts Vicious Mockery as super effective.
You're a short motherfucker and nobody likes you.
You wanna die?
Jesus Christ!
What did he say?
You wanna die? Yay! I'll start working on this little guy so we can get you all cursed up!
You're awfully sunny for a dark mage.
Okay, so that's a Crom one.
You want to do Sully and Crom?
We'll do that in a bit, because remember, I have Crom with all the other ones he can do as well. I'm seeing which ones are, like... I'm seeing, like, the other ones, basically. I think we're through them all. Okay, it's just, let's do, okay, here's what I think. We'll do the Crom ones, and we'll do me with Syrie and Anna, and then we'll move on and we'll do the others next time, because now we don't really have any other supports to work up to.
Okay.
So, Crom and Sully.
Hey.
Oh, hey, Sully.
Oh, hey, Crom, I forgot you were in this game.
Hey.
I know, Crom. Hmm? Where are you taking all that equipment? Would you like some help?
Yeah.
This is nothing. I keep trying to clean up around this crap hole.
Good.
Seems like every time I see you, you're working like there's no tomorrow. Just try not to overdo it, all right? It's not worth it if you wear yourself out. Wearing myself out, huh? That's the point, Crom. This is part of my training regimen.
What?
You're training to clean a tent.
Right.
God, but you didn't. I'm training my muscles.
Didn't you ever watch Karate Kid?
Knocking stuff is pure strength and a head of a lot faster than sparring. Also have to balance and coordination, you know? All that crap.
Really?
Guess that makes sense. Plus the tent gets clean.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've always been efficient like that. Any chance to train is a chance to take. Bet you build up some real strength. How about a little demonstration?
Oh, yeah?
Come out to me, little man. Just don't start crying with the light the four with you.
Crom and best friend Vake, who he hasn't spoken to in 4 years.
Hey. God, it was Vake. Am I Vake?
You.
Ugh. It's fine time, Crom. Very well, but on one condition.
What?
Condition? It's not like you to ask for a handicap.
No.
Nothing of the sort, Vake. It's just that, Alyssa was pretty upset after our last duel. Poor girl was crying her eyes out. She said we were taking our sparring much too seriously. So I insist we do it with these balloon swords.
Tweak!
Huh. I mean, whatever, I'm up. She made me promise to go easy and fight safe so neither of us gets hurt.
Right.
Yeah, that last clash was a real doozy. Good times, good times. But, this is Krom. You gotta have to explain this fight safe concept to me.
Right.
This headgear? Meh. Been pondering that myself. Perhaps we could decide the winner with a coin flip? Good gods, no. I don't want Lady Luck picking the winner. She hates me. Not between us, anyway. I got it. What say you and me have a good old-fashioned cooking contest? Make something, I make something, we see who comes out on top.
Really?
It, I suppose, though I was seldom allowed in the castle kitchens growing up. Yeah, you're right. Cooking against royalty would be like spearing fish in a barrel. If I can't beat you with honor, I got no interest in beating you.
I will not fail.
Hold on now. I didn't say no. Roasted my share of campfire boar and have heard no complaints.
Looks like Teach just got 10 years.
And the cook-off it is. Get ready to taste my victory.
Still love that line he had. Looks like Teach just got tenure. Alright, Krom and Frederick now.
My lord.
Just doing the test of all the voices, ain't you?
Yeah.
Going to my patrol of the encampment, my lord. All appears to be in order. I found no sign of the enemy nearby. Believe you are safe here for the night.
Good.
Good to hear. Thank you, Frederick. All of my rounds, I took it upon myself to inspect our weaponry as well. I placed any items that showed exceptional wear outside your pavilion. Be your choice to sell or repair them, sire. I recommend swift action. Oh, well, you have been busy. Your work ethic always impresses, Frederick. Almost feel lazy by comparison.
No.
Nonsense. I've done nothing more than my duty as a knight of Elise. I beg pardon, my lord, but I notice you often cause a ruckus when training. With that in mind, I reinforce the tents near any open areas you'd like to use.
Forgive me.
Yes, I see. Sorry for the trouble.
Really?
No trouble at all, my lord. Happy to help.
I reinforce the tents, points to a brick house.
Also, with the nights growing colder, I procured blankets from a nearby village. I have readied a variety of colors, so you might pick which best suits you. I don't know why when he said I've readied a variety of colors, I just imagined him with the classic restaurant coloring mat for him.
Oh, I thought you were going to say he pulls them out of his sleeve like magician's handkerchiefs.
I was like, here you are, sir. Please color in the lines. If I may be so bold, sire, peach would seem to be best to flatter your complexion. Or perhaps blue, just to be safe. Yes, that's best. Blue it is. Here you are, my lord, and two sets of spares just in case. Frederick, do you never tire?
Well,
of course not, my lord. I'm here to serve. And one final thing. I've taken measures to raise troop numbers and morale.
I want it to cut to Frederick, still in his full armor, but with a jester cap on, doing juggling.
I was imagining him doing stand-up. And so then I said, fuck your weapon triangle. Woo!
A funny thing happened.
That man gets it.
A funny thing happened to me on the way to the battlefield today. I killed them.
Woo!
I read this already.
One last one. I was told I'm supposed to come up here and say jokes. Vake.
Oh. And an artisan create posters emblazoned with your noble image. It's my lord in a bold pose. Naked, save a scale in one hand and a sword in the other.
Hold on a second!
At your feet, I scrawled our new recruiting motto, Krom Wants You. I had them pinned inside each and every tent. Surely the troops will be thrilled to rally behind their common leader, my lord.
Huh?
You did what? You hung this in everyone's tent?
Indeed.
No need for thanks, my lord. Merely doing my duty. Sassy Alfred coming out.
Krom, I think we need to have a talk about something.
Krom, I don't need you pinned to the ceiling of my tent that me and Shersher are sleeping in. And that concludes my report. Rest well, sire.
Listen.
And Frederick, wait, we really need to talk. Oh god, I gotta tear those posters down before anyone sees them.
Hey, Krom, I saw Frederick, a poster of you!
I don't know if Frederick was fucking with him or not, and that scares me. Oh, good day, my lord. Hmm? Hello, Maribel. And just Krom is fine, please.
What?
Are you here all alone? Maybe? Checks tent. Goodness, but there's a chill in the air today. Would you care for a cup of tea?
Thank you.
Well, I won't say no. Thank you, you're very kind.
No.
Is there pie? Sumia looms from behind Krom as Maribel gets paler. No? Oh, all right.
Sumia nods and slowly backs away.
Oh, please, for a noble woman of Elysian, royalty is a high honor.
Good.
Signs of peace, maybe, but this is war. Kings, nobles, and peasants alike are all just comrades in arms.
It just reminds me of this line of dialogue from Sonic Forces. It's something like, I'm trying to remember exactly. It was like, none of this is fair, Knuckles. That's why it's called war.
Jeez.
Yeah. Also in Sonic Forces, they talk about Sonic being tortured.
What?
They go hardcore with that shit.
Jeez. I'm now imagining Sonic with like a camo headband and like little black marks on his face. Knuckles, I lost my shoes.
You know what's great? Sonic Forces, one of the most divisive and probably just negatively received Sonic games ever. It's the entire Sonic IDW comic series is a direct sequel to Sonic Forces.
Woo-hoo!
So, one of the best things to come out of the Sonic franchise is a direct sequel to one of the worst things to come out of the Sonic franchise.
Huh. Alright. So please, don't wear yourself out trying to look after me. Yes, but...
You alright?
You've been fighting as hard as any of us. You must be exhausted.
She has been on the battlefield once!
Well, I confess I sometimes find myself wishing for a respite.
Respite.
A Rasputin.
Rah, rah, Rasputin.
But then I remind myself how much harder it must be for you.
Actually being on the battlefield.
Heavy lies the crown and all that, yes. So it is my duty to help you however I can. Your dedication is appreciated, Maribel. A bit extreme, maybe. But appreciated. Just promise to look after yourself as well. We do that for me.
Yes.
Your wish is my command, my lord. But first, let me bring you that tea. I'll take it, thanks. I so very much enjoy our time together. I pray we find opportunity to do it again. I hope so, too.
By the way, I put up these posters of you. Alright, Krom and Gaius.
Hey.
Gaius, do you have a moment?
Huh? What's up, Blue?
What?
Could you put my fucking cookies? You'll never find them all. Right. Well, you must have traveled a lot in your odd line of work, yes?
Old line of work.
Yep. Odd line of work.
Sure did. Us thieves tend to outstay our welcome in a hurry.
No.
The reason I ask is I've had little chance to see the world properly. Journey on diplomatic business, but that's pretty much it. And frankly, one majestic court looks very much like another. I ought to wonder what it would be like to roam the world free of royal burdens.
Oh, yeah?
You royals up your pointy towers really don't have a clue. You think us commoners are free to just spend our days sauntering along? Think we pick daisies and gaze at tourist attractions and eat bonbons all day?
Forgive me.
Look, that's not what I was implying at all, and I think you know it.
So what's the problem? Tired of silk pants and the undying adoration of the masses?
I try and appreciate my situation, but being a royal can be incredibly stifling. It's a comfortable prison, true, but a prison nonetheless.
Sounds like a serious case of not being able to count your blessings.
Right.
It's true. I'm never hungry. I have a hot bath and a warm bed. People leap to my aid. I have lots of money. Perhaps you're right. What right have I to complain of such a life?
Bingo. All right, I'm glad we had this talk. Now, Crom and Olivia.
Yes.
Hey, Olivia, what are you doing here all by yourself?
My lord.
This was you.
I know, I'm trying to remember the voice. Oh, my lord. Crom, sir. Sir, my lord. Hi. I like to come here for peace and quiet, to relax.
Really?
Then I'm intruding. I'll leave you to your...
No.
I mean, it's all right. I don't mind, really. Hmm? Well, you're sure you don't mind? Not very talkative, are you? That's all right. I was never much one for...
Well...
Oh, look at the time. Gotta go.
Hey.
Olivia? God, I'm supposed to be the leader of elite and commander of the army. I can't even talk to my soldiers properly. How am I going to rule my subjects? Or inspire people? Or forge alliances with other nations? But every time I try and talk to Olivia, it ends in awkward silence. Well, no more. I'll find a way to break through if it kills me.
Alright. So, let's go to...
I'm also glad, Sylvia.
Yeah. Alright. Sairi.
Hey.
I have a question for you, Sairi, Sairi, I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm. And I shall strive to answer it.
It's about your armor. I've never seen anything like it. Where did you get it?
Right.
This, it is a common enough sight in Johnson. All warriors wear a variation.
Oh.
The shape is unusual, but clever in its design. The plating looks tough as well.
Hardened lacquer. It keeps the armor light while providing excellent defense.
Hardened liquor?
Lacquer.
Liquor?
Licorice.
Hmm. Guy pokes his head in. What?
It's quite rare to see heavy armor where I come from. And we wield a curved single-edged blade in both hands, so we do not carry shields.
They have got curved swords. Curved swords.
I see.
That's a far cry from what I'm used to. Are there any other important differences?
Right.
Aye, Wordsworth, sir. You'd find much of Johnson culture curious. Food, dress, most everything.
Hey.
I'd love to hear more sometime, if you don't mind, that is.
So be it.
Of course, I would be honored. Talk of my homeland keeps it close to my heart.
That was nice. Now, Anna.
Hey.
Someone's cheerful today.
Mm-hmm. Eek! Oh, sorry. I didn't notice you there, Maximus.
Sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to scare you like that. I was just wondering what you were laughing about.
Yes.
Well, I just sold some inventory at 3 times the price I paid for it.
That's great, so long as I wasn't one of the suckers who fell for it.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, if you don't know the game, you shouldn't make the deal. But don't worry, it wasn't you. There's nothing like the feeling of when the coins hit your hand.
If you say so.
Oh, I do. I tell you, the path to happiness is paved with gold.
Huh?
But there are some things money can't buy. Important things.
Hmm.
That's a load of bull plop. And even if it was true, money makes you care less about not having those things.
Hmm.
I don't know.
Cha-ching.
I love money. Money, money, money. Money, 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 SpongeBob.
Clink, 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 go the coins. All right, we're not going to continue with that one. I can already tell what that one's like. All right, are you ready for actual progress now? Actually, hang on. What's the Blessed Lance again? Is that... Oh, no, no, that's not the one I want, then. Alright, are you ready, Rhino?
Alright.
The Demon's Ingle. Sibling Blades. Rhino?
Just as I thought, Jung Luke's only made a show of opposing us. We're clear of them. But Yen Fei's forces approach swiftly, and it won't be long now.
Right. We should hasten south to meet them and distance ourselves from Walmart. This battle will be challenging enough without the Conqueror breathing down our backs. Rhino, are you falling asleep?
A little bit. Another concern. The Dynasts who betrayed us.
Get up and stretch or something.
They attacked us and let us go both because it suited their purpose. Should they attack us from behind as we battle, Yen Fei would have an easy victory. They would curry favor with the Empire without risk of injury. This is how they think.
Hmm. Rhino.
Rhino, we cannot defend two fronts. We'll need to choose our battlefield carefully.
Rhino, get up and stretch.
No, that will make the dogs start barking.
Do something to wake up.
Sorry, that mountain. I've seen it smoke for hours, but I see no trees on it anywhere.
Nay.
But, that is no forest fire, sir. It is a volcano. Have you ever seen one? That one is called Demon's Ingle. It is known and feared by all of Valm. If you dare even get close, that's the anger that we could fire god.
Hmm. You're not done, Rhino.
Maximus, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I see.
Only if you're wondering how quickly we can reach the volcano. Rhino.
Go to the Demon's Ingle. You do know what you're saying.
All right.
I'm saying your opportunistic former friends wouldn't dare risk following us. And we can use the flames as barriers to limit how your brother's army approaches.
And my brother will still come. His stubborn pride will force his hand.
Right.
It seems we have our strategy.
Rhino.
It is a risky plan, but I can devise a move no better.
Rhino.
And you two seem to have a peculiar talent for performing miracles.
Okay. You might be able to get some sleep done while we're doing this, then.
Alright.
Well, there's Yen Fei. There's a lot of treasure chests out here. I don't know if any of them are going to be going for it. Let's see here. This is all good for the group we want to bring. Let's divvy up. Okay. Very tight passage over here. Let's
you in front. Yeah, Noir doing the looting while everyone else does killing is what I'm thinking here. I think Noir will get paired up with Cynthia for that. Let's see. Lissa will stay in the back of this. Well, no, let's put her in the middle. Okay. Rhino, I think you said you wanted to voice this guy next time he showed up.
Why, General? Such a melancholic air about you today. Whatever is the problem? Oh, is today the day you face off against your beloved sister? Dear me, of course it is. Well, then of course you'd be in a foul mood.
She is a rebel and traitor to the Empire. I have no sister.
Really?
Oh, very good, very good. Right out of the book, General Yinfei.
That is the look of constipation.
I commend your acting ability. Very convincing. I think your men all heard you. In any case, I'm so glad I can trust you not to take it easy on her ragtag little troop.
Rhino.
Yes, we both know why you'd never let any of her comrades escape, don't we? Oh, I know it must be so difficult, General, but think of it this way. You still have a family, a big one. The whole Imperial Army is your family now. And I should run. Do tell your little sister I say hello. Ta-ta.
Huh. I don't like that. Right. Hang on. Options. Turn all that back on. You down. Gregory, go ahead and get the sparklies. And start moving on. All right.
Donald!
We've long grown past concoctions at this point. To be fair, Sylvia, those weren't crits. Those were soul activating, which is just, he heals him. Still unnecessary. Unnecessary. You can't hit Donald, or Jerome, or any of us, really. See what the like chance of that proccing is. What is the chance of this even happening? Skill stat. So it's a 44% chance of happening each time. Huh. Should have about one in every two attacks. Yeah, but it's Donald. He does whatever he wants. I know.
What's up?
Still snoring.
Sorry.
Yeah, Morgan is just kind of doing everything herself. Yes, a balloon.
Success.
Something we so need. Yeah, we're kind of just going through everything here. Am I really not able to, Yeah, there is no way for me to adjust the... Adjust the difficulty once we've started, and that's disappointing. There was it still wouldn't be useful given they literally made a money grind. It's not even that, right now the fights are me one-shotting them and they are literally incapable of hurting me. And like that's why I wish I could raise the difficulty. I guess what I could do is just, like, switch to my weaker members, but,
Rhino.
What's up?
Snoring again.
Sorry.
Energy drop, that's good.
Caught it myself that time.
I mean, the Wyvern's gotta land, Sylvia. Also, lava's pretty hot even if you're not touching it. Alright. Hey, Sairi, how about you be the one to, do this? Just makes sense. Rhino?
What's up?
Some dialogue here. Sairi is fighting her brother now.
Oh, God. Brother, I want to ask why. We are well beyond that point now. I will speak it plain. I cannot forgive you, and neither can I let you live.
I've asked you for nothing, sister. Least of all your forgiveness.
But you will have my justice, like it or no. You who stood by in silence while everyone around you suffered.
Yeah, it's hot, but that's like me getting hurt for staying near an open flame for too long and looks up at that shit for hours. Lava is not... Lava is much, 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 much hotter than just an open flame. Like, that shit will fuck you up just by being near it.
While villages were razed and fields burned, you watched but said nothing. When father and mother were murdered, you said nothing. Nothing, before you ran to the arms of the one man responsible for it all. Your silence was deafening, maddening. Even now, have you nothing to say?
Yanfei!
Damn you, Yanfei! Then I will make your sword answer for you. Draw your blade and let it sing your final words.
Good job bringing her.
Yeah.
Lethality. Damn.
That's not, as far as I can tell, that's not a scripted thing. That's just an ability she has as an assassin. Lethality, she has a chance of just one-shotting the enemy.
It was very cinematic.
Yeah?
Sairi, you have grown so strong.
Do you mock me? I have seen your best sword play. That was not it.
I literally didn't even get to swing my sword.
Exactly, you suck. You went easy on me, but why?
What I could not tell you in life, I say with my death.
Yanfei!
But Yanfei...
You have found strong comrades. I no longer need fear for you. I die in peace.
How do you mean?
I mean, considering all the other shit she says he did, I don't know if that'd be in peace.
And Faye, wait. What do you mean? Why? Don't leave me with more silence, not this time. Yen Faye.
You stabbed
me. Get your ass over here.
I'm dead.
Ooh, you got sword.
Oh, a better rapier.
Ooh.
There were no heroes today.
Why? What happened?
I don't know. Hang on.
I appear to be awake now.
Yeah, Also, Sylvia, I just looked it up real quick. Magma, which is what video games tend to call lava, is... between 700 and 1300 degrees Celsius, or 1300 to 2400 Fahrenheit, roughly. That is definitely too hot to just sit nearby.
Yeah, considering you can't even stand that close to some fires when they get hot. Trust me, as someone who burns a lot of things, I know this.
Did you read the line?
Oh, is that what you were waiting for?
Yes. Well, I was also just looking up the thing on the side, but...
Oh, did you not hear my response?
I heard your response about the thing about the magma and the heat and the fire.
Okay, good.
It was just like, did you read the line, though?
Okay. Our victory is secured. Yanfei has fallen. I will never understand why he joined Walmart. His reasons die with him. Lord Krom, we found Yanfei's diary. Oh, damn it. But, oh, what a death it was. Did you see the grief etched on his face? The mix of longing and pain in the eyes. He had become such an accomplished actor, but that was all too real. Excelsior, I mean Excelsis. What would you know of my brother, you loathsome fool?
Excella, that woman villain for Resident Evil 5.
Excel spreadsheets, what are you doing here? More than you, Princess of Kronsin. And I would watch that Princess of Cookie Monster. And I would watch that mouth of yours. I am honoring Yenfei's sacrifice by not killing you now. But even I have my limits. What? What do you mean, sacrifice? Oopsie, did I just spill the beans? I'm so sorry, but I promised your dear brother I'd never tell.
Fight.
Explain yourself, Snake, or die.
Really?
Bah! As if you could harm me. You only live by my grace, you ungrateful wretch.
Donald, get him. Her, I actually can't tell.
Ah, Donald. I could have killed you countless times, and I would have, if not for him.
How do you mean?
Enough talking around it. Say what you mean. Mm. Oh, did Yanfei not groan out the truth as you cut into bloody pieces? No, I suppose not. He was always so quiet and proud. Honorable, I think they call it.
To be fair, Sylvia, I imagine Excellus here is talking about, like, before Sairi joined us. And at that point, she was level one. So, we took more damage from the lava than from you bitches. That is true.
Yet he swallowed his pride and cast aside his honor, all to protect his beloved kin. Although kin apparently didn't include his parents. That's right, little sis. He did it. To save you. What? Lies. You're lying. No, I'm telling the truth, which I admit is a rare treat, so you best shut up and enjoy it. Before you met these Elysians, I could have had your head with a word. In Cookie Monster, at Val Harbor, did you really think yourself so elusive?
At Valhalla.
You were my leverage for Yanfei. Unwitting and unbound, but a hostage all the same. I let you live. He fought for us. That was our deal. And he kept his end right to his end. No. No. Well, I don't know about you, but I feel much better having that off my chest. Maybe I will give this truth-telling a try more often. Yes, I shall resolve to do so. In any case, goodbye, friends. I wish you safe travels, and so sorry about Yanfei. Oops, I broke my resolution twice already. Teehee. Away!
Yanfei.
No, this isn't... This can't be. Yinfei, no.
Krom and me just standing there awkwardly.
Sorry. God, it's the things I said to him. The things I did. I have wronged him beyond imagining.
Ellipses.
If he had only spoken, told me, I could have joined the ruse.
Lady, I know well the grief of losing family with so much yet unsaid. Just go back in time.
How could this happen?
I am wretched. I've repaid my brother's kindness with death. Oh, Yinfei, forgive me. Please, oh please, please.
Alright. Sairi, I'm sorry, I'm so sorry.
It's so interesting seeing Lissa without her dress.
Yeah.
Sairi, you did all you could. Your brother knew that. You're blameless in this. Excelsior. It's just excessive, and the Empire are at fault here. And they will be made to answer for it, I promise you. Sir Krom, I pray forgive me. You've done so much for this land, while I can give nothing in return. Or worse, what help I offer turned against us.
Hey, we're the resistance now, and we've yet to lose a battle. Yinfei would be proud.
You are oddly happy.
And he'd also want us to fight on, to make sure his sacrifice has meaning. Also, I admit, my happiness is probably because the guy we're mourning, I literally never interacted with. And fight we will, Sairi, until this land is free.
My gratitude.
Aye, sir, and thank you.
I get that she's supposed to be crying, but it looks like Lissa is just making an M shape with her hands and arms.
Y-M. What was the next letter? I owe my life to you all, and to my brother. I swear to you and to him, I will make the most of it. Did I say the conquest or the compass?
No idea.
When do we have time to erect this building?
Sire.
Lord! Con Basilio! He has been killed in battle!
No!
Lucina. Motherfucker!
Gods.
Damn it all, you're certain? I am. He's gone, Krom. I saw him fall myself. He's gone.
I'm getting out of here!
Flavio, what happened? Wait, you're hurt. Your armor was never red before. Lucina, fetch a healer at once. I'll be fine. Gaunt's down to me. I'm trying to lock onto her accent.
Italian.
Is it? I thought you were going Dracula.
I'm going Italian. What it ends up sounding is irrelevant. I'm going Italian.
I don't know an Italian.
God damn me for not leaving that.
It's very Mario-esque.
Exactly. Do you know what? Did you know Mario's Italian, Rhino?
God damn me for outliving that. Just sticking to Irish, apparently. For outliving that one-eyed claw, that big bald oaf, that. Arr! I know what the sound is, but I'm not good at doing it.
That's twice now I have failed.
I could crush you.
I'll kill him. I'll cut that dastard Walmart down myself. I swear it before the gods. No, Flavia, for now you need to rest and to heal. When the time is right, we'll avenge Basilio. You have my word.
Then know that I will hold you to it.
Why did I let him go?
Kralom, there's something else. Something important. Basilio asked that I give you this. I'm getting there. I always imagine my voices for people on, like, the axis of a control stick. It helps me, like, get my tongue in the proper orientation. Hmm? Wait, is that... Ah, I can feel its power resonating throughout my whole body. Why is it so low poly? Why does it look just really zoomed in?
All we had was a PNG to work with.
It's Gulls, one of the gemstones you need. Don't ask me why in hell's name the orf hid it from you. He always did love his surprises. Damn him.
Right.
Whatever his reasons, I accept his gift now and gladly. It's hard to believe he's truly gone. The larger the man, the larger the void left in his wake.
And Con Basilio was a titan. There is no replacing him. I should have tried harder to convince him.
Neat. Alright, Max. With this gem, we're halfway through the campaign.
Now.
Scouts have reported back.
She looks like she's wearing... Like, she looks like she has blades coming out the back of her wrist.
She does.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
Walmart's army has retreated to the Imperial capital. That's the assassin garb.
Retreated?
Right.
Scenes of Dynast Turncloaks are withdrawing their soldiers as well.
What?
I don't believe it. Good, I'm lying. Steiger and Yinfei have fallen. It's no shock Walmart might pull back to regroup. And of course, the Dynasts now see cracks forming in the Empire.
Really?
Maybe they'll reconsider which side they fight for?
Yes.
Possibly, if they can see an advantage in it for themselves. With them or not, it seems a decisive battle is upon us.
Do you really want people that turned on you, though?
To think how quickly our fortunes have shifted.
Yeah.
We have Basilio to thank for it. For all of it. His sacrifice made it all possible. If only there had been some other way.
This is where he shows up still alive, right?
No second guessing. Basilio would have hated that. You did your duty as best you were able, same as he. Now clear the doubt out of that clever head of yours. We're going to need it. The fate of Valm, of all our homelands, hangs on this next battle. Really, already? Jeez. For the sake of history and all our fallen comrades. We'll bring this empire crashing down.
Listen to me.
Shepherds, comrades, Rex, soldiers, we make for the capital. This conqueror's reign ends now. Are you sure? We only have 2 stones. I guess we didn't necessarily need the plot item.
Walmart has one of the stones.
Ooh, was that a paralogue?
Yes, it is. Divine Dragon Grounds, paralogue 17. Well, I mean...
This sounds like we may get a certain someone here. Solar says they think he'll pop up later and say, I live, bitch.
The threat of silence.
The air is sweet here. It's so calming.
Right.
Makes you want to just flop down and take a huge nap, doesn't it?
Tempting.
Odd. Seems like anywhere else to me.
No.
This is Naga's cradle. It said the divine dragon once called this place home. Here, the voice will enact a holy rite to commune with Naga and regain her power. What up, fuckers?
Lady Tiki.
Oh, wait, is she just traveling with us?
I don't know. I think we just found her here.
Huh?
Lady Tiki?
Fai.
Pray be silent, my lady. The voice is currently performing the rite.
She might have been traveling with us and just not been fighting.
In doing so, she will draw the divine dragon's powers from the land into herself.
Forgive me, I didn't realize. I thought she was sleeping. She looks so peaceful. What do you think she sees? Does she perchance dream?
Hey.
I think all the Manakeets are sassy fuckers. I imagine she... is that what I think it is? Sorry, Lucina. Enemies approach us from the south. Better get ready. The voice here is in for a rude awakening. Trademark.
Haha. For a rude Fire Emblem awakening.
Oh, supports. Oh,
well, yeah, no, it's just ours. So, all right.
Oh, we have a defense map this time.
Yeah, but we still have to rout the enemy. So, all right. Wow, Tiki, your stats are disappointing.
Well, you can fix that later.
Oh, yeah. Also, we had that thing that was like, it gives somebody a skill that allows them to earn XP twice as fast. I did give that to Sairi, so.
Neat.
So that has been used. You know what hasn't been used yet, though? Is the boots. And also this energy drop. Let's see. Is there anybody who uses strength whose strength is not yet maxed out? Jerome's strength is not maxed out yet.
Fair enough, Solar. What is a Matsu? It's a sword.
Yeah. Myrmidon classes only. So. But yeah, it was.
So that, only it, Donald could use it?
Maybe. Hang on. No.
Wait, but Myrmidon was like the.
No, our hero was mercenary.
So, wait, who the fuck can use this? I'm not sure anyone can.
You guys never touched Myrmidon. Wait, can you? No. Nope. Yeah, I did, I also, like...
I guess Sevra might be able to use...
No, Sevra's also... I put Sevra up to hero. I put the characters up to hero just to, be able to actually use them when I'm grinding. Yeah, I don't think...
Oh, well. It's a sword class, and we didn't need more of those.
Aw, damn it. Well, actually,
Long Ku music?
Long Ku is a sword master. He can.
Hey.
Ah, okay, that makes sense because, Sairi was a sword master. You know what? I'm gonna.
Really now?
I'm seeing if, like. How, like, what the difference would be overall. Because if I do that, so let's see,
Assassin is a Myrmidon class. Then why can't she use it?
Yeah, she's not able to use it. I specifically checked. Unless it's, like, something that, like, she's not allowed to use it for whatever reason. I got the stuff from Assassin, so I think I will... It's not much of a change overall, so just for the sake of Hera being able to use her brother's sword, I'm going to change her back to Swordmaster. It just makes sense.
Show us that leg.
Her HP is nice. There we go. Right, I was also trying to see, like, giving out the... You know what? Here. You can have the energy drop. Alright, your strength is now maxed out. Who should I give the boots to?
I feel like that was a little bit of a waste.
Who else would you give it to? So many people have their strength maxed out already.
Yeah, give it to Jerome.
You know what? I'm gonna give Noir the boots because she's the one that we use to run around picking locks.
That is fair.
There we go. All right.
I was wondering if you were gonna give the boots to Morgan.
Make her go like across the entire fucking map. All right. Let's see here.
I think Assassin is a Myrmidon class. Yeah, but Sylvia, we literally looked at wouldn't let her use it in Assassin.
Yeah, so I think of Assassin. No, Assassin is a thief class, I think.
But only Myrmidon and Swordmaster could use it.
Oh, well, that's okay. That's just stupid on the part of the people who wrote that description. Also, why make that distinction? But whatever.
Also, by the way, I got a message earlier. Looks like we shouldn't have any issues on Friday.
Nice. All right.
Glad I've gotten a nice nap in, and we're done with supports for the day. Time to make a D&D map. All
right. All right. I think this is a decent setup. You have things to say, Rhino.
The voice is defenseless in this state. We must become her shield until the rite is complete. We await your strategy, Maximus. Make us a wall of steel. Horses fly over those.
I've got walls of steel.
They'll probably be better when she joins the party. I don't know about that. Now let's see if this is one of those maps where the enemies will ignore you to try and get to Tiki. Units with a distance attack will be able to just shoot over those three.
Yeah, but they'll be able to attack them like once it comes my turn again.
If and, she I, lives.
And I'm blocking out the amount of spaces they actually have to step on. Let's see. Yeah, they've got three on each side so far.
Yep, they're trying to just pass you. Who the fuck are they?
More enemies.
Hey, wait a minute. Why did they show up on the ally phase?
I don't know.
Well, now that I know this...
Well, begin killing.
Accept your fate.
We've discovered the chance for a soul there to pop up is 44% because it's based on the skill, but it seems to happen every time Donald attacks.
I love it.
Vengeance!
Vengeance for your not missing HP.
That's it.
Well, good thing Noir's here. She can shoot them while they're not on the map. Granted, death funnels where they end up moving next to people who can kill might work. Yeah, we'll see. Technically speaking, I guess if you make lines of people, they won't be able to go through. They'll have to go around. I don't know about that.
She gets extra movement when she's carrying someone.
Yeah, but now you have half. Now you only have one person to kill things.
I have a plan. Just give me a moment here.
And I'll let you cook. Also, on Lamax, I intend to actually use Tactician Special Masterclass.
Tactician has a special masterclass?
Yeah, we went looking for that, and it didn't seem like it had any. So you don't want to attack any of those three enemies right there. Ah, fair. Jeez, you pretty much have to kill everything that appears. That, or I guess you can cluster the hell out of Tiki so that you fill up all spaces in a 2-block radius around her, and then they can just come to you.
Yeah.
You just gave up her extra kill there.
I know.
Invincible.
In Fates, Grandmaster is DLC exclusive.
Do they only have flying units?
Starting to look that way.
Jesus, blow his head clean off. You plan to do the cluster around Tiki Strat?
More or less.
Why does I wonder why the transformational rules of the Dragonstones war?
I assume that, like, in universe, the Dragonstones are used up based on how long they're in that form. That makes sense. That makes more sense to me.
And yet, in some of those supports, it seems clear that at least Nah was using them. I would move one tile down from that, if that'll work.
Is it over?
Kill you because you have magic. I think Morgan was a mage when we first got her.
She was a wyvern rider because that's what her mom was.
Right.
Panic. Close the net.
No more of them are appearing.
What is challenge?
I mean, I'm pretty sure the Tagwell and Manakeets don't stay transformed because the longer they're in that form, the more the Dragonstone is used up. And what we're seeing in terms of uses is just how many times it could be used for combat, for how long it takes for them to do an attack.
Hope you're ready.
I think we'll be able to get through this. Sword hand.
You can't stop me!
Let's go ahead and heal Tiki. Just in case some shit happens.
Is it bad I sometimes forget the person you're guarding?
Garbage witch kill voice.
Heroes were Lucina and Cynthia.
Are you unharmed, Lady Tiki?
Thank you.
I genuinely forget who voiced Tiki.
I think it was you.
Yes, thanks to you. I apologize for the delay, but the rite has borne fruit.
You've taken in the power of the Divine Dragon.
Yes.
Some of it, yes. It's strange. This power had always isolated me. Many were the days I wept alone, cursing the charge placed before me. Lady Tiki. But now my power has a purpose, and the world needs it to avoid a ruinous future. And so I shall offer it freely. Allow me to join you.
But don't you see?
Are you certain? I am. I've had quite enough of living in solitude, thank you. Besides, I've always longed to better know this world. Now I can help you save it.
Alright, now we have Tiki. Who has Dragonstone Plus? Wait, does that mean we cannot buy Dragonstone Plus from here? Hang on, she's selling an energy drop.
Take your time.
Also, Thoron. Wait. Yeah, Brave Lance, grab that. Okay, there was you. Oh! Seraph robe.
Oh, come on in.
All right, let's have a look here real quick. So, yeah, the stats are... They could be better.
She just needs a couple grinding and reclasses.
Yeah, hang on a second here.
Carry only the finest.
Oh, I can't. Huh. Weird. The other one I was able to just choose Manakeet again. Huh. can't use that. Alright, I'll just do this the back and forth way then. Doesn't really matter. Mage. Now I have to get her up to level 10, but that's fine. We weren't going to be using her anytime soon anyway. Alright. This isn't like... Okay, no, so... Alright. Let's go to the barracks real quick. Is this a Tiki thing? No, it's a Cynthia thing. Alright, also, let's take a look at this now. Yeah, Tiki has supports with Mia, Lucina, Sairi, Anna, and Na.
Huh, interesting.
Yeah. Don't know why Anna. Alright.
I carry only the finest.
Give me just a moment here, because, one... Yeah, that's fine. And I'll just do it. I'll do it later. Alright. Let's see. Next big thing would be here with Chapter 19. Do we want to do that, or do we want to do a DLC thing?
Hmm.
I think let's, it seems like we're like, getting to a good, climax point. So...
Yeah, but would you rather do that, or would you rather have Tiki up to snuff so she can participate?
I mean, she's just another mannequin, right? We kind of already have Nah for that.
Yeah, but I mean, like, Sairi is someone who we could have done without, but you liked doing it because she had plot importance.
Yeah, but Tiki was a paralogue character.
I suppose that's true.
Also, what is this? Repairs at adjacent allies' equipment. Oh, so there is a thing for it.
How many uses does it have?
One!
Zeh, not worth.
Yeah. I think we could just, like, we have Tiki, that's great. Let's just keep going now. Like, we... I'll get her up to snuff later. I got Sairi up because... Also because with Sairi, I was like... My thought process was like, yeah, we do have, like, sword users, but we don't have, like, her kind of type. Also, you know what? You know what? I'm going to turn myself into a grandmaster.
For shits and giggles?
Yeah.
Or because you think you're going to start using swords?
I'm probably not going to start using swords, but it allows me to level up more. Also, I no longer have the weird fishnet chestplate. There we go!
It's funny because you start out with max magic.
Alright. I'm gonna give Jerome the energy drop. Alright, he is now at 48. And then we also have the Seraph robe. Whose HP do we want to increase? Crom's.
Did you see what Sylvia said?
You won't be able to use black magic? That's fine.
I'll admit, the only reason I was using black magic was because I could. I don't really care that much one way or another.
What can I fix you with?
Go ahead and buy another Arc Thunder. Alright.
Let me go tank them out real quick since Spectre's being loud.
Alright. I'll maintain equipment real quick. Through and being like, all right, what needs to be replaced? That's fine. Get you a new silver axe. Got this for you, and this for Jerome. Here's what I was wanting to get her, is this Brave Lance. I'll go ahead and, I'll have her keep this. Get rid of that. Actually, no. Hold on to that. Robin in Smash Bros. Ultimate uses all levels of magic. Yep. It's Elwind for the recovery. The neutral special is basically Thunder, Arc Thunder, El Thunder, and Thoron, depending on the level you charge it up to. Right special is Arc Fire, and then down special is Nosferatu. Okay, so Owain needs a bow. Siren needs a sword. And this stuff for Alyssa.
I carry only the finest. What can I fix you with?
Now, for you. Aw, really? I think that should be good. Aside from, let's see, load myself. I'm pretty sure I have some other magic that I've been holding on to.
Let's see, I have this Thoron. And I can grab this Arc Fire just in case, for whatever reason, it's better. And now let's sell things.
What can I fix you with?
Boop. Surprised you don't just decide to pump their upgrades all the way up. I mean, I do that for some of the stuff. I can't do it for everything because they have a limit. Yeah, I think that should be fine. Just make sure everything... Equip that. Just make sure everything... They're all equipping this... They have the stuff I want them to have. You should have an Arc Thunder. I'll grab you one in a minute.
I carry only the finest.
Arc Thunder. There we go. And then for me... There we go. This is good overall. We just wait on Rhino. Once he's back, we will continue. Alright.
I now have this bowl.
Bowl of what?
Pineapple.
Okay. He just cut off in Discord, so all I heard was, I now have this bowl.
I now have this bowl.
So I altered some equipment and such. Krom now has the Noble Rapier, which I have named. Sir Poke the Third.
Why is it Sir Poke, not Sir Pokey the Third?
Because that was too much. That was too
many, much?
That was too many letters. I have a lot of electricity along with my Thoron, the plan. Lucina still has her stuff. This is all most of the same. Morgan now has a, Micaiah's Pyre has been upgraded and named to Book Bonk. I think that's all I did for, Cynthia, I gave the Brave Lance and upgraded it, and it is now Dynamic Entry, so she has both now.
Yay.
I'm gonna have her go through Grand Entry first. Like, I just like Cynthia having the Brave weapon, because then she attacks four times. And it just makes sense, she's just so hyper. And then everything else is the same. I considered getting Owain a bow that I upgraded and named, like, Tom. Wait, hang on, I know exactly what to do now.
What can I fix you with?
There. What are you talking about? It's perfect! Anyway, let's go see what's going on here. Vom Castle Approach. Chapter 19.
Chapters ago, we were like, there's no way we'll be able to beat it. Now it's just like, you know, suddenly I think we can.
The Conqueror. The way it looks like Frederick is stopping us from going in.
You will go no further, sir.
I'll kill you all. I am Frederick.
Where is his army?
No.
No sign of them yet, my lord. Do we really need to narrow down on you saying and then unnarrow and then narrow back?
Yes.
Meanwhile, Maximus thought, but back to everyone else. I don't like it. It could be buying time.
Buying time? Waiting for what?
For this nuke!
Yeah, the fools have no idea what they've just stepped into.
Anticipation before a battle.
I'm gonna play that voice clip again because now that we're in an actual Fire Emblem stream. I discovered that Cervantes has this voice clip that can play sometimes in battle.
See how my mustache moves in the wind!
And it's great.
My hairs stand on end, every one of them! Makes it difficult to brush, if I may say. But today's struggle will set the course of history once and for all.
Also, I thought we killed him.
Yeah.
What?
Today's struggle, Cervantes. I think you mean today's slaughter.
That's the spirit, tactician.
Really?
Wait, I just finished explaining this to you. What is wrong with your ears? The resistance will destroy itself. You and I needed so much as lift a finger. The Elysian League thinks the Dynasts no longer fear us. But they don't understand how persuasive my methods can be. They'll know once they see their former friend lives to their backs.
What? Chives and flapjacks, you say?
The battle is won before it started, and without us risking any further casualties. If I do say so myself, and really, no one else is capable of judging. Ah well, tea, Cervantes. I have a stash of Grey Root Blend here, simply divine.
Why, Excelsis, thank you. It is quite a... isn't it? Or what?
imbecile! Stash! The tea! Why do I even bother? Get a decent conversation out of anyone here. I swear, they're all either screaming for their lives or dying loudly. With the intellect to appreciate my talents.
I like to imagine Cervantes knows full well what he's saying is just fucking with him.
Well, aren't you an evil-looking bastard?
Yes. All right, I think you were voicing him last time, but because it occurs to me you're voicing all the fucking villains, I'm taking him.
Fine. Speak as someone who's so tall his horns of his sprite poke off screen.
Cervantes.
Jesus, fine.
Yes, my master.
Who is the pinnacle of man in body, mind, and spirit? Who is greater than the gods?
Does he have a gem in his forehead, or is that just his brow furrowing very well?
No idea. Also, that hurts.
Only you, my master.
A meager effort.
Well, Excellus, that seems to contradict your last statement. What say you?
Why did your voice change?
I had a frog in my throat. Literally.
Ew.
Here it is now. Holds up half-digested frog.
Ew.
Throws it at Excellus.
I assure you, I meant no offense. I only celebrate achievements in your service, Master, to your glory.
Stand up and fight.
Glory is won on the battlefield. Glory is meeting your enemy's eyes and watching the hope drain away with his life. Glory is not one holed up in a castle with plots and cowardly schemes. And I'll be dead before I let some dynast farm lord take today's glory in my stead.
Why, yes, of course. So well put, my master. I only meant that...
Shut the fuck up! I'm leaving now. I thought he was gonna come back!
That sick mind of yours sees much successes, I'm much certain. But for someone so clever, you really can be quite dumb.
God, these fools!
What? You dare speak to me like some child? Like your equal?
Your equal? No, fear not. I will never think of you as my equal, worm. I would shave and wax up before the fight. Tum, tum, tumpity, tum.
Think they're all so great just because they wield armor three times the size of a normal person? Broom-faced twit. To hell with him. With both of them.
What was that?
That was me sighing. Now, Excelsis, keep your wits about you. They're all you. Besides good looks. Let Walmart charge ahead, the big stupid lobster.
What did you call me?
I'm discussing dinner. I'll end up on the winning side one way or another. Getting a little development at the end there.
All right. Jesus Christ, we have a lot. Okay. Hey, there's Walhart.
Most evil mages do, Sylvia. Hello, Unstoppable.
I guess Cervantes and Excellus will show up on the field later if they do it all. Alright. Let's see. Who else do I want to bring? You know what? I got Sevra leveled up to 20 and then turned her into a hero. We're going to see if she can actually do stuff. And then...
makes her kill Ballheart.
And then,
die.
Huh?
I said she'd probably fucking die.
You know what? We have not used Henry in a long time. But I guess his magic is kind of meh. His magic stat.
Look, we got a big enough ace squad.
Brady looks like a fucking toothpick in his silhouette. Who have we not used in a long time?
Yarn.
Strength zero.
Zero.
We'll bring Yarn. Yarn and Sephra. Alright. Alright, let's see here. Throw in Cynthia in those spots. Noir and Wayne there. Let's see. Have them paired up with some standard sword folk. So Lucina and Sevra. And then Donald and Syrie. And as for us, we'll be running back. Well, no, I guess healers should be in back. Ones on horses will be in back. Okay.
Really?
Rhino?
Damn mute. That's him, isn't it? Walmart. Brave of him to face us.
Right.
Brave. Aye. Wants to enjoy this himself. Oh! That's an armored-ass horse.
You do your sister's legacy proud, Prince. But humanity already has a savior. A conqueror who broke stronger men than you when they refused to bow. Warriors of Vaum, ride with me now!
Courage.
Together, we will stamp out this final pack of insurgents and unite the world!
When you said Warriors of Vaum, I could only think of like a shorthand for vomit. Warriors of Vaum!
Hip hip!
Can we see how many of the Vaumese troops remain after one turn? Because they currently have 35 troops.
Alright, we'll go on a killing spree.
Let's see how many die in one turn. Alright. I'm Donald! That's the first time in like four battles Sol didn't proc.
Accept your fate.
Severa.
If everyone attacks, it should only cut them down by 15. So the question is, how many of them will die on their turn?
Yeah.
Oh, he did.
7% chance crit. Hey, she has 69 health and 69 XP. Nice.
Nice.
And her hit is 169. Nice.
Eh. Want to go hang out in one of the forts? Alright, no.
No, I want to murder.
That guy could have actually hurt you.
He didn't, though. Huh. Oh, I guess because they make it hard to move. That's why it's, like, not letting you do that. All right, yeah, die. This guy will actually... Never mind. Overkill! Good. Cynthia took damage! Lucina took damage!
Gasp.
You're fucked now, buddy. Cynthia fully healed herself! Destroying that guy.
You can do this.
War, watching half his troops just disintegrate.
I think I've made an error.
All right.
Prove yourself.
Call in the reinforcements. Let the cavalry rain upon them like a blizzard of swords.
So 15 of them died between our turns. And more than half my guys couldn't even get close enough to attack them on their turns. So, that's pretty good in my opinion. They start with 29 troops on their turn. They are now down to 20. Yep. Fuck up his horse, Yarn.
I hate horses.
I hate fire-breathing horses.
Is it a ranged sword?
Yeah, it has range. I figured it was just like the Levin sword. It would like summon magic or something.
Nah, it's a heat sword.
She just fucking threw it and he ceased existing. He was removed from the timeline. Need any of that fancy shit. No crits, no triggers, not even a double attack, just breathe fire and be done with this shit. The way he runs up is great. Not taking anybody's shit. Gonna return home, build like a brick house, smiling out, be like, I murdered an entire army!
I mean, you're not wrong.
I also married a buddy, and this is my son!
From the future.
He married a princess!
So you know, I think we're gonna be alright.
Oh, Walhart goes wherever he damn well wants, actually.
Oh, unlike most bosses who are like, I will not move from this spot.
Yeah.
Or is that his attack range?
No, that's his movement. Because it's blue.
Okay. Also, what's that skill he has?
Conquest. Protects from bonus damage against beast riders and armor.
Eh.
And then Soul may absorb HP equal to half damage dealt. Trigger percent is skill stat. His skill stat is 26.
I mean, 25% chance to do any of that. Terrible. Will you have Morgan just murder him?
We'll see. Let's see if he ends up unintentionally killing himself here. My friend failed at that! I bet I could do better!
Oh, exactly lethal? Hold on, let me fix that. Yeah! Although with that, I don't actually know if she can kill him. Oh, nope, she will.
Behold! I am Walmart the Conqueror! And you are but a pebble upon my path to immortality! Perish! Uh-oh.
No, you. Yeah. What the fuck? What is this plot armor bullshit? Oh, wait, no, technically she actually did do just enough to leave him with one health.
Yeah.
Again.
Hey, that's exactly what I wanted. I want a chance to kill everybody else first.
I think this is the last one. Get him.
Yes, yes, he is. No, never mind. I literally cannot get out of his range. Oh, well.
Oh, well. Go, Morgan.
Hang on. Stab!
Damn, in the chin.
You think you have won? You blow as if to douse a candle, but you only stoke the fires of hell! I'm dead!
Lots of bodies around. No, I'm pretty sure we won.
Yeah.
Okay, I got another. The heroes were me and Crom.
No.
Walmart has retreated into the capital. Fie, will this war never end?
Yes.
His men gave their lives to secure his.
No, hey, his men were all gone! And the person who killed him had another turn. If this was in D&D, this is where I would go like, no, there is literally no reason why they wouldn't be dead now.
They won't lay down arms until he drops. Does.
Now.
Then we must pursue and see that the deed is done. I don't really like that there's a missing spot in our five formation here.
Who be those bitches? Damn, we're surrounded. The dinosaurs ride against us. Hold, sir. Look.
A save screen! I'm sorry, but Lucina and Cynthia butchered like 9 to 10 people. I got no idea, man!
Not these fools!
He'd lost? But how? How could the conqueror be conquered?
Did you notice that my hat from the side looks like a sailboat?
Ooh. He's insurmountable, incontestable, invincible.
Inconceivable, inevitable.
But that means... Oh, my. Goodbye, then. Do see to it that, What the fuck? I lived on 1 HP. How do you keep doing that?
Going somewhere, tactician? And Siri literally beheaded a man with a thrown sword at that.
Master, I was just coming to make sure you were upright. Are you hurt?
Yes.
Rally our forces at the capital. We will put an end to this here.
At once, my master. Only, have you considered perhaps waiting just one day? I do have the dynasts and their men on the way with them to help us.
Have you seen the battlefield? No, I suppose not. Do you get to the
people to do that for?
Do you get to the Cloud District very often? Oh, what am I kidding? Of course you don't. Take your head from wherever it's lodged and peer out into the daylight, snake. I'm sure your mighty intellect will quickly understand what's happened. Though if you had half the metal of that Elysian tactician, you'd already know. We should have been romancing our soldiers the whole time! That's the secret of their power! Not even joking, it literally is!
Master, I don't,
Yes, sir.
The dinos, sir, from the Southlands! They're making to siege the capital!
But that's impossible! We had an agreement, just like I had with... Oh, dear. The Southern Tinus. Did I find out about Yen Fei? Maybe I shouldn't have gone on an exposition rant. This boggles the mind.
Do you recognize them?
How do you mean?
Aye, sir. They're from the Southlands. States that betrayed us for the Empire. Or so I thought. Well, their allegiance seems to clear enough for now.
Fine.
I can hardly believe it. Theirs are the lands my brother commanded. Finally, now they come to answer the call.
Very nice.
Finally is right. It's taken a lot of hard work to get here, Cyrene. A lot of sacrifice. From you, from Basilio, from your brother, don't forget this moment. Excelsius, you fucking dogs, you got me monologuing.
What's the, that's from Monty Python, isn't it? It
no, like that. that's from Invincible, or Incredibles, actually.
Oh, okay. I just don't remember it then.
Hi, my lady. Hi.
Are you ready?
Now let us finish what we began. To the capital, friends.
It's been a long time since I watched Incredibles, okay? Give me a break. Jesus Christ, Anna's everywhere.
Let's go see what they got. Spirit dust?
Magic.
Ooh. To the next Anna.
Yep.
Oh, come on in.
Ooh, brave stuff. Alright.
Woo!
Take your time.
Armor Slayer.
We have two of those, we're fine. She's not gonna leave, but. Alright, real quick, let's go ahead and give some of this out. You know what? Gregor, let's give you the Brave Axe! Let's see. The Brave Bow Noir. And then, let's see. We have Spirit Dust. And I think that's the only upgrade thing we got, so let's see. whose magic could stand to go up? Morgan's is not maxed out yet.
Really? I guess half the time you use her for melee, but still.
Gregor and Jerome are our axe units, Sylvia. Let's see. Could give it to Lyssa for better healing, but otherwise, yeah, no, let's just give it to, Alright, maxed out magic now. Where's Book Bonk? There's Book Bonk. Alright. Vaughn Castle, Chapter 20. Only two axe units whenever we have so many lancers. I mean, we have Morgan, who is a mix. Cynthia.
I was about to say Morgan, who's a myth.
Actually, we only have two lance users, Morgan and Cynthia. Like, we have more, but those are the ones we use. Swords are what we have the most of, because Crom, Lucina, Donald, Syri, and Owain. But, I mean, Crom and Lucina kind of have to be sword users. I mean, I guess they could use lances, but... And then Donald was, like, our original hero, so... And Syri just needs to do this in order to use Amatsu. Yeah, go ahead and real quick empty out any random things we have to pick up while we were doing all that, now that I think about it. Oh, you picked up an extra thing. You don't need that. All right. All right. Are you ready, Rhino, for Vaughn Castle?
I guess so.
This feels like the sword or the knee. This feels like the finale of this arc. And I think after that, we'll be back to focusing on DLC for a little bit. At the very least, doing another DLC plotline.
There must be several hundred thousand soldiers out there. Would they dare? Is it possible? Is it possible it was Yen Fei they feared all along and not me?
Without him to back it up, your threat was only the grand shadow of a tiny spider.
Tiny spider, is it? Well, this spider has woven other webs in secret you could not even...
You mean how you blackmailed Yen Fei to keep his loyalty? Or perhaps your correspondence with the Plegian woman? Aversa, was it? Yes, I know you have designs on the Fire Emblem. You have no secrets from me, worm.
But I don't... if you knew all that, why...
Why haven't I killed you? I've asked myself the same thing several times. But you're no threat to me. And I admit you have your uses. Besides, I'm not one for court jesters, but you do amuse me.
Not these fools!
Amuse you? I amuse you? Like I'm a jester? Are you amused now, with a million swords at your door, and you've lost, and you are going to die, all of you, but not me. I was no part of this suicide.
Why, Excellus, did you just volunteer to lead my personal guard against the rebels?
What? No, that's...
Unless you'd rather fight me right here, right now!
Mercy, forgive me, my master. A moment's demand is only. It will not return.
Then it's settled. We have our new captain of the guard. Congratulations, Captain. You'll be right at my side until the fray is upon us.
Where did he go without going down the stairs?
Do give our guests a warm welcome, Snake. Perhaps offer them some of your tea. My ha! Goodbye.
Really?
They forget who I am. I could have fried both of them where they stood with my magic. We will crush these rebels. We must crush these rebels. Or maybe, if Walmart is sufficiently injured, I might amuse him with a spell. Either way, this spider crawls out alive. I'm having fun voicing him.
I hope he dies soon.
Oh, he probably will.
Oh, hang on.
There he is. That's... Wait, what? Hold on. He's gotta be in here
there's
somewhere.
Cervantes.
Okay.
There he is!
There he is! Behind a wall of, like, fucking 15 people.
Dude...
It's 11, but still.
Dude, your magic skill is pathetic.
Ooh.
Your magic skill is 25. Pah! Jerome's magic skill is almost there, and he doesn't even use magic! Noir's magic skill is higher, and she doesn't use magic!
Chat votes for Syrie killing him.
Killing,
Excelsis.
Excelsis? Alright. Okay, I get that he's standing with, like, his axe drawn, but it kind of looks like he's in a position where he's, like, leaning in his chair. Like, leaning back.
He's on a horse, though.
No, I know, but, like... If you
Wolfberg?
Huh?
Wolfberg.
Walhart only the Conqueror's Great Axe. Hmm.
It has a range of 2.
Probably throws it. Alright. Let's see here. Oh, alright. Noir's gonna be on the... Alright, hang on. Anna, we're bringing you in. Actually, hang on. Anna and Gaius both have it. I think between them, Gaius is actually the better one to use. So, Gaius, we're bringing you in for the sole purpose of unlocking a door. And then we're going to keep Yarn. All right.
Unlocking a door.
A door and some chests. All right. So, the first wall we're kind of facing is Cervantes, then after that is Excelsis, and then after that is Walhart. So, Syrie is definitely going to get the kill on Excelsis. We don't have anyone with a mustache that can challenge Cervantes's. I think Morgan should kill Cervantes, because she killed him before, and, like, literally ignored his entire army in the process, and it was just funny. Alright. Noir and Jerome over here, and then Cynthia and Gaius over here. They'll be tearing through there, and then they'll be backed up by the Transformers, and... Yeah, I think this setup. And then we have the big guys up in front.
And then, okay, I think this is good. Let's do it.
I see Walmart still seated in his throne room, but also on his horse.
He's seated on his horse in his throne room.
Doesn't seem like he's thinking about escape.
Whoa. And his soldiers, they look ready to die before they'd surrender. One must admire their loyalty, at least.
Right.
He does inspire that in people. It's part of what makes him so dangerous.
He inspires that in some people.
Hmm. Yes, in some. But not me.
Can't kill him. Alright, we'll get to that shortly then. Alright, Alright, hang on. Let's go back to normal. Normal view. Lucina, it's Pokegirl still won't kill, never mind. Percent chance of crit. Also 7%. Hey, 7% chance of crit. Hey, do you know who I am? I'm Donald! Donald! You are a soul thought. Here to kill you. Rhino.
Yeah, let's talk. Retire then, Rivera, you scum. Like a flimsy belt around the waist of defeat, you shall buckle here. See what I did there?
That's a weird one-liner. Anyway, die.
What do you mean? I am worried to be the... No, lightning. I am finished again. But I have no regrets.
I die in the shadow of greatness.
I'm gonna cut his mustache off!
Becca Shield.
Yep, and now she sits there and lets everyone come to her! Aside from this one. Unnecessary, but at least we get to see that! All out attack.
I must do more.
Sure.
It's always funny when she defeats them with sparkles.
Yeah. Doesn't have access to Aether and Smash Bros. You're using it a lot. Killed Cervantes, and that's about all you've missed, Solar.
My strength is yours.
A lot of unnecessary crits and stuff as well. Miss Exceladine yet.
Now I'm angry.
I forget if I asked you this, but Rhino, have you played Fire Emblem Fates?
I have. I completed the I've completed one side, didn't complete the other, and I didn't play the third route at all.
Gotcha.
I kind of got bored.
Wondering if maybe we'll stream Fire Emblem Fates after this.
Yes. We have a lot of things.
That's fair. I'm just saying, like, it might be on. I might go on the list. Go ahead, Rhino.
Oh. You think I'm afraid of you? Come then. Come at me. Oh, I missed.
Vengeance! What's wrong, Sylvia? Yeah, Siri still gets the murder.
I'm a healer.
I'm Donald! I'm a healer! That barely doesn't actually get there.
Start heading out here now. Hey, we have a longbow now. Siri, get kill now. Let's do it.
Really?
Oh, there you. Is not.
You! You and Yennefer cost me everything. Yennefer. I only pray my brother is watching. Yennefer, guide my hand.
Oh.
If there was ever for a time for lethality, it would have been then, but... I got baloney.
You got baloney.
Donald, why don't you get these sparklies? Just keep everyone moving up. A lot that baloney is spelt the way it is. I hate it. Unnecessary crit.
You would challenge the conqueror himself? Yeet!
Yeah, I just beat you in another map.
Rally every last man! We make our stand with Emperor Walmart!
Guys, get the loot! Hey, Dragonstone Plus!
Hey.
Hey, Beaststone Plus!
Hey.
It's, go grab that.
Careful, he might go into range of someone else. He might decide to just murder your healer.
He just killed himself.
Do you see? Often the sword is the only way. My conquest ends here.
Hey, I leveled up. Heroes were Lucina and Jerome, really?
My lord.
What is this? A fucking my lord.
It's fucking what? What?
That was like, my lord, we ride the enemy. Neat. And then we leave. Well, our soldiers have agreed to cease hostilities. Finally. Then pull our men back immediately. Strange, Frederick. Walmart and my sister were complete opposites. One gave her life to stop a war. The other took lives to create one. Yet they both inspired those around them. Both walked a path to end all war. Both lived and died trying to unite the people.
Yes.
Yes, Father. But as they say, the method is the message. Your father suffered from beliefs similar to Walmart, and his legacy is plain to see.
These are matters too weighty for this moment. There will be plenty of time for reflection now that the war is done. That is a green-ass gem. Sir Krom, 1,000 thanks from every Valmese couldn't repay what you did for us. But I recovered Vert, the gemstone that was stolen from Kronsin trophy.
Chonsin. It's an H, not an R.
Stolen from Chonky as a trophy. Giving it to me?
Right.
Of course, sir. It seems the fell dragon will soon threaten us all. I would feel safer knowing the gemstone was in your hands.
Good.
And so it will be. Thank you, Siren.
Now we're outside!
Are we packed and saddled? Our business in Valm is finished, but we have another task ahead. Perhaps even more dire than we faced here. Tilistol!
Hey, we're here! I know that. Every time, Twink walks up, Krom.
Don't forget, your brother is the evil deep-voiced Maximus.
I know that face. Dueling with unpleasant thoughts, are we?
You know me well, Maximus.
Hey, remember when Lyssa first brought me here? When I met all the shepherds? And Samia? Oh, what a day. Actually, that's my first memory, in a way.
I suppose so. I wish all our memories since could have been as joyful.
Yeah.
I know. So much needless bloodshed. So many days of pain and doubt and fighting. We would have never made it without you there to guide us, you know.
Yes.
Funny, I was gonna say the same to you.
I guess we really are two halves of the same whole.
I've sent Frederick to search for Sable, the final gemstone. And I've been reading more about the Awakening Ritual. Trademark. Seems whoever attempts the rite must brave Naga's fire. If both body and spirit survive the agony, they are blessed with the dragon's power. Otherwise, the candidate dies.
What? No! That is... Father, must you attempt this?
Is this how he dies in the future?
Lucina doesn't know, I think.
Well, no, she knows that he dies. She came from a future where he died.
Young lady.
I'm so sorry.
Forgive me, Father. I didn't intend to. I came to speak with you, but I couldn't find the right moment, and...
It's all right, Lucina. And yes, I'll be all right, too. I will withstand Naga's fire. I'm sure of it.
My lord.
My lord, I have returned.
Hello.
Yes, Frederick, did you find it?
Right.
I believe so, sire. King Valadar has extended an invitation. He says Plegia has been guarding Sable, and he now wishes to return it to you.
What?
Valadar.
Well...
He sent word to me, my lord. They must have caught wind of my search. In any case, Valadar has asked that you visit him in person, that he might formally present it. Perhaps needless to say, my lord, but I don't like this one bit.
Right.
Neither do I, Frederick the Wary. Neither do I. At best, it's selfish political maneuvering at a time when the world can ill afford it. At worst, our run-in with those Risen last visit were no accident. But we will meet with him. Send word at once.
Really?
My lord, are you certain that's wise? No, but we haven't time to be certain. My sister never refused a diplomatic gesture, no matter how foul-smelling. If he doesn't give us a stone, he may at least reveal where it is. Don't worry, Frederick. I'm not walking into this blindly. We'll make certain everyone is armed to the teeth.
We'll bring Donald, Morgan, and Gregor.
Right.
Then the fire, my lord. You ought at least leave it behind.
No.
Unless that's what Valadar expects, and he comes to steal it with my best men away. No, it's safe as with me, for now. We'll learn the truth of Valadar's motive soon enough.
God, those things are everywhere. What are you so... Wow, no thanks. What is the... What is Sol... Well, first off, what are you selling? Not helpful. Wow, no, they're still not selling the plus stones. Huh. Alright, we're gonna be ending there. Next time, we will... Let me have a look at the DLC real quick, because I believe next up is Smash Brethren. Yeah, next up is Smash Brethren. We'll probably go through that, and then, depending on how long it takes, we'll either do the next one as well, or we'll just return to the story at that point. So we got the three Smash Brethren ones, three Rogues and Redeemers, Death's Embrace. I need to point out, it's called Death's Embrace, and the picture is a smiling guy. Welcome to Death's Embrace! 5 Anna Firefight, and the icon isn't even Anna. Roster Rescue, Harvest Scramble, Summer Scramble, Hot Spring Scramble, The Future Past, and Apotheosis, whatever. But yeah, we'll be doing we'll be focusing on DLC next. I think it's gonna be the idea here. I don't suppose we unlocked any I mean, I don't think we unlocked Lucina and Jerome for support. I'm just looking to see if we unlocked any other supports while we were doing all that. Also, be making sure to get Tiki supports when we're between streams, because there aren't many of them. And then these other guys didn't even take part, so yeah. Alright, let's end off with Lucina and Jerome's support that they apparently unlocked, and then we'll end off.
You there?
Something wrong, Lucina. Oh, hello, Jerome.
What?
What's the matter?
No, wait.
I've lost my pendant.
What?
Oh, what manner of pendant? It's carved with the likeness of my mother. It's very precious to me. Where was the last place you saw it?
Well...
I took it off while I was cleaning the supply tent. I didn't want it getting scratched.
You there?
I suppose you've already searched there. Many times. Then we should retrace your steps and see if we can't find it. You'll help me look?
Yes.
It's important to you, isn't it? I'm sure this dog will help us find it.
You have my gratitude.
Yes, very much so. I simply thank you, Jerome. Thank me when we find it.
Alright, that was a simple one. Alright. Alright then, we're gonna end off there. The next time we do this, we will go through more supports, and we will start the DLC. Well, we will start the next bit of the DLC, the Smash Brethren part. Which, I mean, obviously it's gonna be related to Smash Bros. It has to be. They had to have done that on purpose. I'm curious how they're going to do it, because, like, at the time, Korin was not in Smash Bros. And obviously neither was Byleth, so it was Marth, Roy, Ike, Lucina, Robin, and then even Crom didn't come out until Ultimate. So I'm curious, they're not just gonna have us fight the ones that are in Smash. That'd be too easy. So I'm curious what they'll do. Yeah. All right, that is going to end this off. So schedule for the week. Today was Fire Emblem, obviously. Tomorrow we are continuing the Pokemon Black 2, White 2 Soul Link Nuzlocke. Wednesday, Secrets of Grindia. Thursday, we are starting Mario and Luigi Superstar Saga. And on Friday, we are going back to Parchments and Perils.
Woo!
So, see you all then for whatever you come to see. Farewell!